Well, everyone, so in this video, I'm going to teach you how to perform matrix multiplication in C++. So, open editor, I'm using KVC++. So, let's get started. First, you need to import the header files. So, as include iostream, then using namespace. So, next, the main function, event. So next we are going to use three matrices, two of them as an input matrix and third one will be the matrix product will be stored in that. So int a 3, so I am using a 3 cross 3 matrix. So is first is the input matrix 1, next is going to be b of 3 3, so c is going to be the output matrix. So I am giving the number of rows and number of columns to be 3 as a static value. You can also get the input from the user by using R and C, getting two inputs. So now we are just going to get the each element of two matrices from the user. So you are going to use two for loops. 2, 0, I less than 3, I plus plus, for input. J equal to 0, J less than 3, J plus plus. So now in this test we are going to get the input from of each element from the user. So just make sure that the user knows the count of number. Enter there and just go here and just print ij eth element of matrix A. So endl, so endl print in the same line of C in A of I and J. So you can ask why type is open. So it's very much simple. So first matrix can be divided, each element can be identified by its index number. So the first index number will be 0 0 0 1 0 2, second row will be 1 0 1 1 1 1 2, third will be 2 0 2 1 2 2. So first what is going to happen is the inside the first the int I will be equal to 0 and the inside interior j loop will run 3 times. So first int I equal to 0, so j is also equal to 0, 0 0 the element is inputted, next j will be incremented, j will be 1, so 0 1 will be done, next j will be incremented, j value is 2, so 0 2 element will be done. Now j will be 3 but condition will be failed. So next it will go again go to the outer for loop and I value will be incremented to 1. So, 1. So next again it will come into the inner loop, j will be 1, 0, 1, 2, 2 and next 3 condition fails, outer for loop, I will be 2, j 3 times, that's it. The both the loop gets terminated and we have got our 9 elements for the matrix. So similar thing follows for matrix B also, control plus C and paste, change it to B and this one as B. Same thing. So we will do, good thing about matrix program is a lot of copy paste things is work here. So let's execute, compile and run. Just check STREAM. Okay. Compile and run. It's always good to run the program in the module and see, especially in matrix, so that we don't get a big error in the, at the end. So it's working fine. So it's also, you can see the elements here. This is still 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 elements we are getting. And this is the index number of each element. So pretty good. So now we have got all the input elements required. So now what are we going to do is, we need to multiply them and store in the resultant matrix C. So we will just type a message cout resultant matrix is just enter and again we are going to copy it, just paste it and just write it. So inside this we need another for loop and I will tell the reason for that. Int pk k less than 3 k plus plus. So it is C of ij, same stuff over here. Just we are assigning the C will plus equal to. So we are adding C of ij in the product. A of I. Okay. P of K. So that's it. So you're asking me why this K term is there extra. So this K corresponds to the number of columns in the second matrix. So as we are doing here 3 cross 3 into 3 cross 3 matrix, so it doesn't follow, just we can directly give as 3. But if you are using an irregular matrix, so suppose it's 3 cross 2 into 3 cross 3, the number of resultant matrix will be changed, it won't be the same. So for that this K is used. So this K, utilization of this K can be identified only if you are inputting number of rows and columns. I recommend you to try that. So now we are just assigning, so it's similar to C equal to C plus A into B. So that's we have done here, plus C equal to that assignment operator. So now we are just, as we have assigned, so each element 0, 0, 0, 1 of C matrix is stored. I'm just going to print it. So let me copy from here. It's the third time we are copying matrix. So just going to print it. Just going to put C out. C of EJ. And slash t. So slash t gives a tab space at the end, and c out general. So this is why this slash t and handle is, so in order to print it in form of a matrix form, otherwise 3339 depending on the product will be printed in a straight line. So in order to represent the output in the blank form matrix form, I'm using this. So let me run it now. Error is there, I will tell you after running the program so that you can know the error clearly. So we will give 1111 for all the values. So outputs 1 into 1, it will be nearly 3 cross 3. All the values will be 3. I think so. First element. So you can see here, we got some 4, 2, 3 and some big number, some 80 lakhs. I think so. It's 80 lakhs, it's 42 lakhs. So if you know the answer, you are a good programmer. And if you don't, I will tell you why. So this statement is over here. Is equivalent to C equal to C plus A asterisk B, but nowhere in the program we have initialized the value of C over here. So the program compiler doesn't know the value of C, so it automatically assigns a junk value to C. So that junk value has been represented in the form of so that 80 lakh 40 lakh code. So in order to avoid this, just go, we're going to go here. We have already copied the for loop, just control and paste and edit it, and C of I J will be equal to 0. So we have assigned now all the element values of matrix C to 0. So that, so it's similar to sum equal to sum plus I, where we initially sum equal to 0. So this is the reason this avoids the junk value being automatically assigned to that variable. So now if you take this, C equal to C plus A asterisk B. So during the first iteration, I think first iteration, it will be equal to 0. So after that, you can see this first C value will be then assigned over here. So that's not going to be a problem. So for only the first iteration to done. So because the first iteration is most important, because the after three iterations, the first iteration determines the entire sum value. So that's why we are assigning all the elements to 0. Now you know there won't be any error. So 1111 last element, yes. You can see we got 3333 perfectly. So that's it guys, thanks for watching. More such tutorials of any programming stuff, kindly subscribe and support. Thank you.